number 34, the senior, the legend, standing at an impressive 6 feet 8 inches tall out of Petersburg, Virginia, Kevin Rebounding Holloman. And at the other forward spot, wearing the number 22, the 6'4 junior out of Missouri, PA, Ricky the Leaping Lefty Wakefield. At the shooting guard spot, wearing the number 4, out of New Jersey, the 6'1 senior, Ty Billy Funk Pay, out of Philadelphia, ladies and gentlemen, out of Philadelphia. And leading the attack at the point guard spot, number 12, the senior, at 5'10", out of Franklin, VA, Gerald Wheeling Dealing Print. The official for tonight's game will be referee Bob Goldsby, umpires Greg Bennett, and umpire Charles Wan.
Caps knocked out of bounds by Douglas Hines, and the ball will be turned over by Seth Cross.
That means he's taking right there because Doug Hines is about 6 inches over the guard who's taking center position.
Inbound here, ball will be turned
They started Madison Jackson, a sophomore from Leesburg, Virginia. He stands at 6'4".
So under chance, they're going to have to make the half set down to the center off the bench without no order of injury. And winning both of the free throws are Tim Kennedy, a 6'4 senior from Gretna, Virginia. Virginia State River basketball, they're opening possession. Jared River way out in 3-point territory near the right side. Big fouls and a 4-2 is Douglas Hines taking the corner, gets it back out top to Brook. Good across court to the top third. Pay makes a move into the middle, slice it in off the window. No good, rebound, Ricky Wakefield put back up, and Wakefield is chilling for about 10 feet out in the right corner.
He hustled money through that time to get the ball that was tipped off the glass and hit the jumper from the baseline from about 4 feet away.
Ball in the hands of Tony Wonder, inside pass to Darrell Towns, and Towns is called for the charge, made a nifty move to the rack and scored the basket, but
the big man there was short of that time in a big way, right on the chest coming out of him.
And big Darrell Towns knows that ball right way on his own game. He had to work there on the basketball against that team, Jalen Brook. So Duncan Rounds, turn around jumper, bounces off the rim, no good, rebound to Elvin Edmonds. Edmonds pushes it up court, there's a 5-11 standing guard from Dalton, Virginia, stolen away by Terrell Good, and now a foul call, and I believe the foul is going to be against Edmonds.
One thing that we have seen from Virginia State University during this homestand is good solid defense. They continue to play as three players, including Terrell Good, and Mickey Whitfield, and also Ty Poe, track the play on top of Trent Powers.
No doubt about that, and there's Douglas Hines with the basketball. Gets it back out to Pay, working around the line, back to Jerry Brook. Now back to Pay, Pay way out in 3-point territory. Moves right side. Trying to get it into Kevin Holloman. Oh, look at him here. In the corner now to Holloman. Douglas Hines turns around and has the ball knocked out of his hands and out of bounds. Virginia State ball.
St. Paul's open up right now in a 2-3 zone, and they're not having any easy passes coming through the paint right now.
Children have it out of bounds. Whitfield takes it out, gets it into play. Now gets it to Jerry Brook. It's Whitfield, 3-point territory, moves inside, paying for three, and it's good. At the
buzzer. The problem with the team is running out on the shot clock and paying converted to shot for me.
Tim James to Edmonds, and now there's a 3-point attempt by Tony Lundy for St. Paul's, and it's no good. The rebound at the hands of Darrell Towns, and out of bounds. Virginia State basketball coming the other way. Gerald Brook brings it up slowly for the Trojans. It's still Whitfield. Whitfield for three, and it's good.
Whitfield with a hot hand right now. He's still scoring the ball with a total of 5 points in the contest.
One thing is for sure, St. Paul's is going to have to get some hands up on Brook. Here's a pull-up jumper from the corner by Tim King. It's no good. Gerald Brook on the break. Lays it all the way up, then it rolls off the rim. Rebound, top three, turn around, lays it up, and a foul is called
against the Tigers.
You have to put it a heck of a time for Virginia State University, Madison Johnson, at the first time by the Tigers. Like a lightning bolt going right to the glass, but on the pass, the shot was off the mark.
VCU at Oklahoma, or VCU Virginia Union in the conference.
Speaking of Norfolk State, they are unbeaten in the CIAA, and they are going to go to Daniel Gill next Saturday night. 1 week from tonight, the Spartans come to Petersburg, and what a ball game that is shaping up today. Of course, they will have the outcome of tonight's game with the Roosevelt City, but that game could go for a lot of teams here at Daniel Gill. 17-18 to Korea in the first half as Kay hits one of two free throws. Quickly back down the middle. Jackson is scoring tonight for Melvin Jones. And he dunks it in off the glass, and it's good. 9-4 Trojans. Here's Kevin Holloman. And Holloman showing real outside ability here as he pulls up from about 14 feet out and buries it. Trojans up 11-4. So the basketball is Tim King. King over to number 42, Madison Johnson. That'll get about back to Edmonds. Edmonds over to the big man. Another big man that is Kevin Lundy. Now he gets into the Morgan bigger man. Downtown. Back outside to Kevin Lundy. Pull-up shot is Jackson. And that is the row for Jackson. He's doing a great job for 7 tonight.
He is in a wonderful job. He is so far 2-3 from the field. And now so far he's in a 1-3-1 zone.
He's tied to a shot is blocked, but a foul is called. And I believe the foul is going to be on that man again, Madison Jackson. And all first correct.
There's also a 14 foul in St. Paul's right now, and that's going to send Ty Phil on the line, and once again, the shoot.
Only 3 minutes and 32 seconds have elapsed from this ballgame. Virginia State up to 11-6, and Ty Phil had a little trouble tonight. Off the free throw line.
It's pretty uncharacteristic of Ty Phil into the game. That's been a man that scored 20 points in the last few games in the Trojans, Terrain Sears.
And the play is 1-2. He's 2-4 from the line tonight. 12-6 Virginia State. Across court to Tony Lundy. St. Paul keeping the corner now. Darrell Towns gets it. Towns gets it out to Elvin Edmonds. Edmonds way up top in. Much pressure by Jerry Wick. And now back down low, the pass goes to Tony Lundy, gets it inside to Tim King, who lays it up and in for St. Paul. And now stolen away, Madison Jackson on the hustle play, stole the inbound pass by Virginia State, and Jackson now passes it back out to Edmonds, way across court to King, inside to Tony Lundy, and Lundy loses the handle. Here comes Virginia State on a fast break. Terrain Sears inside for two.
He didn't have a lot of people to play the defender, but it took his time to get a couple of offense and got the easy basket for the Trojans.
14-8, Virginia State in the lead. Inside pass, Tony Lundy gets it. His shot is rejected by Duncan Hines. Here comes Virginia State. 2-on-2, 3-on-1. Pass across the top three. And Ty Perry lays it up and in for Virginia State University. 8 points quickly in this ballgame for Ty Perry. 16-8 lead, Virginia State. Tony Lundy inside for St. Paul. Turn around jumper is up. And the shot no good, but he did get the foul call. And let's see, they're going to call that foul against. I believe it's going to be against Douglas Hines. That will be his first foul of the ballgame.
This is the end of the team's second to down in contest. 14:55 remaining. The score is 16-8 for James State. Substitution will be made soon as number 30.
At the line for the Tigers is Tony Lundy, the 6'6 junior of Suffolk, Virginia. And Lundy cans the first one. Trojans, 14:55 to play in the first half. Just under the wall, Daniel Jim, a pretty nice crowd out tonight to check out St. Paul's. I'm very impressed.
Yes, and Virginia State University has been in those W's in the win column, and that will bring the crowd out.
And an offensive rebound now by Tim King.
After Lundy missed the free throw, but King could not hold on to the basketball after that foul. And it was just a big over with 14:57 to go in the first half. A 7-point lead, Virginia Tech 16-9. Here comes Gerald Brick with the basketball across half court. Sets it up to Hadaman. Now back to Brick. Brick makes a move into the lane, gets it to Douglas Hines, and his shot is good. Rolled around the rim. Looked like he was going to roll out for a second, but it got away. And it falls in for Douglas Hines. Virginia still up 18-9. Tim King with the basketball in the corner. Sets pressure. Gets it back out to Edmonds.
Man-to-man defense being applied wonderfully by Virginia State.
He's Anthony Williams just in the ball game, and he drops it off to Darius Hines, who lost the ball out of bounds. And apparently, the official feels the ball rolled off of Towns' leg or something, but that actually looked like a bad call. It should have been seen called ball, but we're not telling anybody, you know.
No, we'll keep our mouths on that one. There's a collision that time with Douglas Hines and also Towns. Towns was colliding to the floor. Hines tried to pick the basketball up, but Towns had the ball rolled off of his arm, big finger, two or something.
Yeah, Jordan, you know, push on that call a little bit, but he's just laughing that one out. Gerald Brick now on the basketball, gets it to Terrell Sands, our final pass in the ball game last week. Todd Payne, pull-up jumper, no good, rebound, Virginia State, inside is Sears, and Terrell Sears picking up right where he left off in the Hampton game, and he's hustling for rebounds, and Ken Allen is picked up that time, 20-9, Virginia State up by 11, and opening up now here in the first half. And thrown away, almost thrown away, first touch by Todd Payne.
Todd Payne being very elusive on the defense again, getting his hands right in the passing lane.
And all the way to the lane, or to the inside, was Anthony Williams, a 6'5 sophomore out of Richmond. And Williams scores a basket for St. Paul's. 20-11, Virginia State on top, 14-14 to play here. In the first half, Gerald Brick inside the Hadaman, turnaround jumper off the front of the glass, no good. And now, Elvin Edmonds, who corralled the rebound, is called for stepping on the baseline. And little mental mistakes so far, hitting St. Paul's here early in this ball game. Enabling Virginia State to really keep a handle on the basketball.
Especially in the 1-3-1 because now they're changing to a man-to-man.
And now it's stolen away by Williams for the basket and the foul. And that's going to be two fouls on Todd Payne here rolling the ball game. As Payne really served the best to let Collins go to Williams and go ahead to the basket and do his thing because Williams was trailing on that play. And he was able to do was the foul.
Williams had a clear shot to the right that time. And as you said, it was bad mental foul by Todd Payne as he thinks that he's going to come to the line with his 4-15 remaining. And that's going to send number 20, Anthony Williams, on the line and shoot one shot and try to cut him to the 2013 lead still possessed by Virginia State.
Todd Payne could not handle the pass from Gerald Brick. It traveled into the backcourt and Anthony Williams just out-hustled Todd Payne on that play. Virginia State with a ball now after Williams hits a free throw. And here's Terrain Sears and inside with a short beating hook from the left-hand side. And it falls for Virginia State 22-14. Trojans up by 8 points.
Terrain Sears, first point in the lane to get 2 points.
And a foul on the inside is Darrell Towns. I believe that foul is going to go against Bruce Davis. So just checked in for Virginia State. Of course, Davis, a 6'8 freshman out of Brooklyn, New York.
Davis is one of those players who's been getting a few minutes and he knows what he's been bound. He's played pretty much of a role player to play solid defense and also come down with key rebounds for the Trojans. He checks out Kevin Holland in the basketball game right now.
Well, check it. As Sears and also Davis were there, they charged for a foul to Sears. And that will be his first in the ballgame. Towns hits a free throw, cuts the lead to 7. 22-15, Virginia State on top. So far, after 7.5 minutes played here, Virginia State basically flexing their muscles and showing their upper hand. in this ball game, but can't let a team like this hang around, Jake.
They're hanging around right now. They're only down by 6 points with 12:28 remaining in the first half of play.
22-16, Davis to the line and a foul.
Utilized that time. It looked like the axe came down from Jason right into his back. The shot was no good, but he was fouled that time by St. Paul's player.
The children didn't actually appear that they wanted to get out of the break that time, but when they looked up and saw just how slow St. Paul's was running, I think that means he had good put on the afterballs, and that's what really led to that whole transaction there.
The door of fouls came in from the back-hand side with the personal foul to Ricky Whitfield, picking up his second personal in the game, and Ricky Whitfield is trying to attempt his second free throw.
And Whitfield makes one of two rebounds to Anthony Williams. Here comes Williams breaking away from the pack, cross half court, down in the corner, and Williams is fouled. As Terrell Sears just walked in and said, get him a ball. Kim King with a basketball on the corner for a three, and it's no good. That was Lincoln Wilson who attempted the three-pointer. Here comes Willie Whitney with a basketball from VSU. Inside, Douglas Hines, and Hines has the ball knocked away, and the official is apparently feeling that is not Douglas Hines, and it's going to be a turnover for St. Paul's.
St. Paul's with the basketball, but Jason University is in trouble right now. They want to go down.
Here's a turnover. St. Paul's with a lazy pass across court, and it is converted by Lenny Whitley for Virginia State. A very, very lazy pass here by St. Paul's, and now here's Anthony Williams again going to the basket, and he's done a good job of slicing inside for St. Paul's. Really, he's been the only aggressive player out there on the floor so far.
He's taking a real high right into a habit of the Trojans. He picks up another personal foul in Trojan player. This time it was number 25, Willie Whitley, and Williams was his third line before that time with a man attempt. It didn't fall through for him, but he will be shooting two from the charity strike with the number 22 remaining, and Virginia State leading 27-16.
When Anthony Williams gets that basketball, it seems like he's got his mind on one thing, and that is to go to the hole. And go to the hole he did that time. He generated a foul and missed the first of two free throw attempts. Second one is on the way for Anthony Williams, a 6'5 sophomore out of Richmond. And Williams makes one of two, 27-17, a 10-point lead for the Trojans. 6 points in the ballgame now for Anthony Williams. And here's Ricky Whitfield, fouled in the backcourt by, who knows, Anthony Williams.
Anthony Williams out of his foul trouble. They're not going right now for St. Paul's. They just picked up their 16 foul.
Kevin Holliman now back in the ballgame for Virginia State. I'm looking for Kevin to bust loose here coming up soon, because they have really got a frustrated ball from the league. He hasn't been able to get the final call, and he really hasn't gotten the blitz from the official either. He's really Whitley having trouble handling the basketball. Finally gets it over to Hines. Now the ball's going to the corner. Davis. I don't know what kind of move that was, but it was effective. He just couldn't get the ball across.
He almost came through his own rebound in time to have the ball, but he was the same approach. It's a turnover. Virginia State University is now leading by 10, 27-17.
A slight to the inside by Davis at time, being Davis, as it was able to get the score. And another turnover charge to the Trojans, something that Coach Dan talked about last week, how he had to cut down on those turnovers, which have started to mount up on the Trojans again. It's been some trouble with that early in the season. Here's Tony Lundy, way out in three-point territory with a basketball. Tony Lundy, every bit of 6'6", and a goal score, 250, 260. And now the ball in between the legs of Darrell Towns, another football player type for a body. And he had a little trouble bending over that time trying to get a hold of that pass. Turnover St. Paul's, Virginia State ball.
Well, of course, that's being applied right now by the Tigers. We're trying to disrupt the smooth, fluid motion of Virginia State's offense. Kevin Kennedy's into the contest right now for Virginia State. And he faces number 24, Chris Davis.
And what we're having a little fun in the inbounds, but finally they get over to Holloman. He brings it all the way up court himself, looking for Kevin Kennedy now in the doorway for Virginia State. Now, Edmund over the top is guarded by Evan Edmonds. Holloman move inside, jumper, no good, rebound. Duncan Hines can't hold on to it. And now Calvin Kenny tracks it down. He gets it over to Whitmore. And she has Whitmore.
He's climbed right off the BK2 that time when he got the rebound.
Whitmore, great spin move into the lane. And threw it up on the board and it fell for Virginia State. 29-17 Trojans. And here's Tim King for three. No good. Rebound. Kevin Holloman doing what he does best. Here come the Trojans. 4-on-2. Whitfield all the way to the basket. And Ricky Whitfield out of Atoka High School letting himself lose here in the first half. 8 points now. Quickly for Ricky Whitfield in his ball game. 31-17. Virginia State. 9 minutes and 31 seconds to play. And Towns is fouled. I'll tell you, see how that little official certainly loved the game on his
head. They blew on the real high, too, and Calvin Kennedy was the first time down in the middle of the game. But if you said that the Virginia State University defense, you know what they have been doing the last 2 games, that is getting steals and converting on the other end of the floor. The last time down court, Willie Whitley was running a bit to the Virginia State. By Willie Whitley, the left side of the floor, how long did he got the easy slipper in the Virginia State? And now State leads 31-17 with 9:29 remaining.
Into the ball game for St. Paul's and St. Paul's senior Will Montgomery out of Jamaica, New York. And Montgomery will check in along with the team's leading scorer, Melvin Jones, out of Richmond, averaging 19 points per game. He's fourth in the CIAA in scoring, and now Melvin Jones is finally in the ball game after Coach Schroeder has been letting sit now for over 10 minutes.
So I guess he's going to really get warmed up and play for 30 minutes of basketball instead of the whole 40.
Well, sometimes the coach can have plans and have been changed. At least a 13-point lead at times in our plans.
Oh, yes.
31-18, Jordan's up by 13. Gerald Burke lost his last half court for Virginia State. Now to Doug Hines. Hines, jumper, yes. Douglas Hines with patented turnaround jumper so far. He's done a marvelous job for Virginia State in this 93-94 season. Douglas Hines has really worked on his game in the offseason, and you can see it. We got a bottle at the South Pole last year, and they're good at all. Douglas Hines has really spent a lot of time in the gym over the offseason. Here's Tim King for a team. Had a foot on that 3-point line, we only get a two. 33-20, Virginia State up 50 on the play of the first half. Inside pass to Hines. Turnaround, no good. And it's batted back out to Hines. He gets it to Brook. Good over there. Here, Height now the ball goes for Virginia State. And now Brook sets it up for the Trojans.
Is there a high school in this first class and quite a rock at Virginia State University, man? He is being effective right now in the Trojan offense.
Kevin Holloman swings up top to pick up the ball, and now he gets a return pass inside, and Holloman lays it up there, and that is 4 points for the 6'8 senior from Petersburg. Here is Melvin Jones with the basketball. He gets it back out to number 34. That is Mario Haskett, and Haskett misses his three-point attempt. The rebound, third floor by Virginia State, but a foul is going to be called against the Trojans. Haskett, a 5'11 freshman out of Newport News, in the ball game for St. Paul's.
the foul was excessive time to go inside. He got the ball clean, but fouled him a little bit with the body, and that was in the Rick Harris on the line to shoot two. The Rick Harris is a sophomore forward standing 6'5 from Hampton, Virginia.
And that is some kind of grace on the leg of Tony Lundy there.
He has it really wrapped up that day.
I'll tell you, that's a big brace there. Looks like, extensive damage or perhaps he had some operations on that knee. He certainly has a protected right.
There's all types of Velcro and cotton, all types of fabric way on all wrapped up around that knee.
Will Montgomery takes one of the two three balls. And 35-21, Virginia still on top. Now a foul called inside.
It's going to be on number 40, Tony Lundy for the Tigers. And that's going to be number 2 on Mr. Lundy. And I'm going to say number 55. They charge number 42 for the first and foul.
7:54 to play on the first half. Virginia still having a little so far. We have been on gymnasium tonight. You have time to BHA basketball, 94, at the Trojan Sports Network. That one is going to be a few meters from Ettrick Colonial Heights.
That's about a number 42, as you already talked about. It's not a 42 and a 4. It has to be a number 40, as we said earlier, Tony Lundy. And for Mr. Lundy, that is the second person.
Going to the line will be Marcus Taylor, who just checked in. Coach Taylor, a freshman tonight, 6'10", out of Waterville, Connecticut. He's kind of had an up and down here. He's got some bright spots, but he's still working hard for the Trojans. He missed a free throw, and now a three-point attempt by Tom King. And King hits the shot, and all of a sudden, St. Paul's is back to an 11-point deficit. 9 points now for King in the ballgame. 7:36 to play in the first half. Minute and a half ago, and he's yet to contribute, Jake.
He's yet to contribute, but he hasn't played in the game, and you're having a leading score on the bench of year. A squad that has only won 2 games in the season, I think he needs a leading score in the game.
Kevin Holloman with a better look shot, did not throw a rebound to Melvin Jones, and he gets it out to number 34, Mario Haskett. Now to Madison Jackson, he pulls up to three. And Jackson hits the shot, cutting the lead to 8 points now for Virginia State. 7 points for Madison Jackson, the 6 foot sophomore from Lewisburg, Virginia. Inside to Taylor. Taylor loses the basketball. Here's Melvin Jones with a steal, but it's taken back by Calvin Penny. And a pass to Taylor, not a height. Height, pull up jumper, 15 feet, it's good.
Six thirty-seven
on the clock in the first half. Virginia State pulls it back up to 10. In the corner now to Tim King. Back out to Haskett. Haskett back in the other corner. King for three. No good. Rebound Taylor. Taylor looking strong on the boards tonight. Gets it out to Brick. Brick. Double with the Danny Rice, and now we're missing the left side in the corner.
Now he's just going to start the offense with 24 seconds remaining, only 35. He said he's got 10, 37, 27, 606 remaining.
And here's Kevin Holloman. Holloman with a turnaround, it's good. And St. Paul's quickly pushing it up the floor to get it in the hands of Will Montgomery. He went up very strong. The 6'4 senior gets the foul. And Will Montgomery goes to the line for St. Paul's to shoot two. And to try to cut this Trojan lead down to 10 points once again.
Mr. Montgomery has 1 point already, but two times he has had the ball in good position. They have been trying to take it right to the left inside of the Virginia State University defense. And he's going to try to cut down on the D right now.
And Montgomery is 2 first one. 39-28, Virginia State. Chip and 5 showing on the clock for Virginia Auto. 5:55 to play the first half. And Montgomery misses a second shot. 11-point lead Trojan. Isaiah Height brings it across half court for Virginia State. Gets it away and across to Kevin Holloman. Holloman with a move to the basket. No good. Rebound to Marcus Taylor. Stolen away. Back up St. Paul's. 2-on-1. And a layup by Melvin Jones is no good. But he gets a foul call against Joe Wood. And Melvin Jones will go to the line now to shoot 10 for St. Paul's. Both teams in the bonus. Both teams are in the bonus. And the reaction is getting out of the
Well, a lot of times in this engine game, came away with a big steal in the 55. Marcus Taylor tried to go up strong in the lane. And when the 10-1 foul took St. Paul's to get the ball to their leading scorer, which is Melvin Jones, who had tried to get the point into the scoring column for the Tigers.
39-28, Trojans. 5:37, left in the first half. Jones. It's the second lead period, and makes it a 10-point lead now, 39-29. Chokin's on top. Virginia State with the ball, Joe Wood inbounds it to Isaiah Height. Back to Wood, Wood walks it up the floor, a one-man press in the backcourt, and he gets it into Holloman now, back to Wood. And let's see, a foul's going to be called. You're not seeing a contact, but what's up the official here for it?
No figures are being stuck up in the air right now, so I don't know why we're able to stop it and play with Virginia State University. They just broke a successful 1-3-1 trap attempt defensively by the Tigers. Had a minute to try to do something with the ball, but now have it again in their possession.
Joe Wood gets it to Whitfield. Whitfield inside the Calvin Kinney. Back out to Brick for 3. No good. Rebound to Montgomery. Montgomery gets it to Haskett. Haskett pushes it up court. He gets it in the hands of Marlon Lancaster. Lancaster just in. He's a freshman as well out of Richmond. 6-foot guard. Haskett with a basketball.
Man-to-man defense being applied right now by the Trojans.
Madison Jackson gets it to Montgomery. Montgomery gets key two in the air. And a foul's going to be called. I believe this foul is going to be against Kevin Holloman. Yes, it is. Kevin Holloman on the foul. Kevin Kinney
came with the big elbow that time defensively for the Trojans. As the Trojan is his second personal foul. And now St. Paul's is in a better bonus situation. We'll be seeing two shots from here on out.
As Kevin Kinney will sit down, he did not play against Canton, and that pretty much a surprise, and really the Trojans played a great game without him, but I really thought they would have made a four foul in that ball game, but Virginia State put a hole in the block, rebounding against the Pirates. Virginia State won a ball after the missed free throw, and this one is 5, and he'll go to the line for 3 shots.
They say his foot was on the line, so he didn't want to get just 2 shots. But it was a nice thought that time for Whitfield. If I was on number 50 for the Tigers, Montgomery, that is his first 18 foul right now for St. Paul's. 2 more fouls, and for the NBA, they'll be in the better bonus. But right now, they are in the 1-1 situation.
Whitfield, this is the first attempt.
For the year, Ricky Whitfield is just shooting 67% from the charity strike.
And Whitfield is 2 on the second attempt, 40-29 Virginia State. What a big game this is for the Trojans. You wouldn't think so, going at St. Paul's. Blocked shot now inside by Holloman. Rebound fought for by Virginia State. Taken away by St. Paul's. Will Whitley comes in and robs everybody. Finally, Madison Jackson gets the basketball. Pulls it to Melvin Jones and a foul is called. And I believe this is going to be against Kevin Holloman, but even more importantly, Ricky Whitfield is leaping in pain. Basketballs, and sometimes that will bring you James, but there's no other way to play but all out.
Well, Ricky Whitfield did lead the James State University in scoring against Memphis 38, 13 points in that contest. He likes to get out there real early starts, even 3 pointers and jumpers where necessary. That's now he's off to a good start as well, as he has 9 points right now for the Trojans.
Melvin Jones cuts the Virginia State lead to 9 points as he hits both free throws, 40-31. Now the inbound to Isaiah Height. Height pulls up for three, and the rebound taken away by Bruce Davis, and the foul's going to be called. I believe it's going to be against Montgomery, but my calculations have not been correct most of the night, so am I correct this time?
You are correct this time.
Okay.
That's the second person on Mr. Montgomery, and Bruce Davis will be on the line for Virginia State to shoot 1-1.
I was about to make an appointment with Lynn's practice yesterday.
It happened in the mall. It's going to be located for me.
We don't want to go that far. 40-31. And the free throws missed by Bruce Davis. And now, here's Melvin Jones displaying what we already knew. That he is a weapon scorer. As he exploded to the basket that time, went by everyone. And caught a half on the lane, but the ball went through the hole. And St. Paul's is within 7 points.
Fouled all that time by Bruce Davis, number 24, and that was his first personal.
Fortunately, for Virginia State, Jones misses the free throw. And the Trojans get the rebound. 5 points very quickly now for Melvin Jones, who just checked in with 9:45 to go in the first half. Trojans turn the ball over, taken away by Marion Haskett. And Haskett gets it up court to Montgomery for a three. And no good, but he gets a long rebound. Move inside. Montgomery did a lot of luck in that time. And a couple of more steps, he may have been in trouble.
He's definitely traveling down 460 that time, and the traveling car was called by the referees. Virginia State University only has a 7-point lead with 3:31 remaining in the first half of play.
3:30 on the clock, as I said, James. 40-33, middle quarter to Height. Height pull-up jumper, no good. Rebound, tap-up, no good by Bruce Davis. Now pulled down by Tim King. King on the run for St. Paul's. Gets it across half court. Up court is King. Slides the feet for no call. Marion Haskett now with the ball.
Virginia State University employed once again in the man-to-man defense with 20 seconds remaining on the shot clock.
And Haskett now dribbling around the three-point arc and lost it, but stolen back by Montgomery. And now no foul call, a lot of contact. Here comes Virginia State. Gerald Brick, great pass to Whitley. He missed the shot. And Height picks it up and lays it in. Virginia State. Whitley had a snowbird that time and blew it for the Trojans. But unfortunately, Johnny on the spot with Isaiah Height. Now here's Tim King for three. No good. Rebound, Melvin Jones back up. And the shot is no good. Rebound, Tim King. Turn around. Knocked away. Stolen by Virginia State. Isaiah Height on the run. He gets it to Brick. Aiden O'Connor back to Height. And the Trojans hold it up. They get it to Bruce Davis inside. Shot, no good. Rebound, Whitley. And Whitley is fouled on the play. Virginia State will go to the line and shoot two. 9 point lead, Trojans.
That's the type of hustle we've seen really, really accustomed to him going all out 110% to try to get ready to get on for the game. That time, Bruce Davis took a shot on the lane. The shot was out of there. And really, Whitley was hustling in and he didn't down the shot. And he was fouled in the process that time. That number 324 would be Melvin Jones.
Really done a magnificent job of turning this team around here since the new year began.
He has been focused the coach for our game, and he has been instrumental in giving this coach a team that a lot of questions asked in the early season about how they're doing too, but they have come to play for 94.
Whitley misses both free throws after missing the snowball moments ago. And now, here's Tim King with a basketball for St. Paul. His shot is blocked. And Whitley redeems himself quickly.
With a kidney climbed up by right into the concrete and five games jungle underneath the St. Paul basket. And St. Paul will have the basketball with 22 remaining on the 35.
Inbounds to Haskett. He hits the three-pointer. And then St. Paul.
And he hits the bottom of it up for Haskett. It's his 12th out of the three.
And the St. Paul's is now closer than they've been in quite some time. A six-point lead, Virginia State. Bruce Davidson's shot is no good. Rebound to Madison Jackson. He gets it to Haskett. Haskett gets it in the corner to Anthony Williams. Williams trapped in the corner. Back up top to Haskett. Haskett over to Tim King. Makes a move inside off the window. No good. Rebound fought for and brought down by Virginia State is Gerald Britt. And Britt gets it over to Sean Miller now in the ball game. And a bad pass by Miller as he was picked off in the lane. St. Paul's on a fast break. And the shot was missed by Tim King. But Willie Ridley is called for the block. And going to the line will be Tim King, the sophomore senior from Gretna, Virginia. King already has 9 points in this ball game. And
both teams have 10 fouls at this point. Willie Ridley just picked his second personal on the blocking foul. And as you said, that's Tim King in the line to shoot two. But the free throw roll for both teams is continuing so far in the first half as King with suspension.
Well, the halftime stats here, certainly going to be extra calls over. Tim King hits the first shot. Second one is on the way. That's on his board. 42-37. So after all of this noise and hoopla, St. Paul's is right back in this ball game. Gerald Britt with the basketball for Virginia State. Gets it over to Sean Miller. Miller back to Britt. Britt thought about throwing Miller for the ball. It's a brick, a cinder block even.
It was going out off the ground. You never let Virginia State get the rebound with under a minute to go in the half.
That was one of those bangers. And Britt now trapped and gets it in the corner to Whitmore. Whitmore all the way into the lane. And Whitmore will play in the ball game after being semi-injured earlier. Comes back with a missed pass and a missed move to the hoop. And now a foul is being called. But again, back to Whitmore's shot. A great move after the Trojans were shot out of the corner. 11 minutes for Whitmore in the ball game. And he continues to be a spark in the
University of Virginia. University is not a half player. It's now Stacey Golden, a freshman from Bowling Green, Virginia, standing 6'4", is in all these pockets. So everyone else seen a little bit of the hardwood tonight for Virginia State.
And Tim King has seen a lot of the free throw line tonight as he sinks the first shot.
14-4-3. And King currently has 11 points, and he's trying to lead all scores with the next two-point attempt.
King hits the second shot as well, and now St. Paul's closer than they've been since early in the ballgame, 44-39, a five-point lead for Virginia State. Whitmore with a basketball, gets it to Gerald Britt. The Trojans are going to hold off for one shot. The shot clock is off, 17 seconds. Whitfield at the free throw line, gets it back out to Britt, 12 seconds on the clock. Britt moves right side, inside pass to Holloman, and Holloman has his shot blocked, but a foul is going to be called with 6.3 seconds to play in the first half. And going to the line for BLC of the Kevin Holloman, the 6'8 senior from Liberty. He would have been very proud of his former Crimson Wave last night, but really did a big on Hopewell. Down at Hopewell High School last night, a big win for Petersburg. And again, congratulations to Coach Bill Lawson.
That keeps the right in the district, both with the number one team in the state. Yes, and Kevin Holloman will be shooting two of the nine. So the first one.
And Holloman misses the second shot. 6 point lead, 45-39. Here's Tim King all alone. Wow. What a turn of events. After Holloman missed it. Right here, Daniel Jim, the second half is now underway to run Fields inbounds to Cook. And if Will Good sets up the offense for Virginia State against the top four. Okay, back to Burt, down 4 point territory. Now he gets it to Dwayne Sears. And Sears, I don't know what he was trying to do, but I think he was trying to draw some contact. Didn't get it, and he the rebound. And the rebound to St. Paul's. Here's Melvin Jones inside. Shot. No good, but the rebound is the own Sears. Sears gets it out of the book. Back across the half court line. Over to Todd Payne, 4 point territory. Payne makes a move. Gets it to Brick for three. And no good. Rebound Hines. Back up, and it is. It is. That was the Brick for Hines.
second, not just going to the first, but the first 47.9.
Down the sideline, 6 points in the crown, so he's trying to get a certain set going in the second half of play.
Now we're asking for the basketball, about to pass third to half of the Williams. Williams to ask him for three, shot no good, and it went to the right, or should I say it went to the cross back, or it's still football, isn't it?
Yes.
Here's Miles and Jones, St. Paul's one score, misses a three. Rebound,
court, but I think that by Perry gets it to Hines, and it got to Perry, and here comes the trophy. Joe Britt brings it across half court, looking inside, can't find anybody, moves to the wing, and it's hacked away by Melvin Jones. Now, the old one's going to be fired on Jones.
Game number 34.
That's going to be freshman out of Memphis.
That's his first foul. But Joe Britt loved the defense. He felt the good drives him down. Making it feel like he's going to pass a little off the ball. But he can close it. He goes into the lane and commits the foul on number 31, Haskins.
Sears inbound to Perry. Perry for three. No good. Foul's going to be against Sears. Across the back, that's going to be Terrain's fourth in the ball game. And he'll have to take a break to Sherman Allen and get some time to
It's a big foul for Terrain since the first pass is Jones. Those two drives around the top of the key, two down low. And with Terrain shoots, let him shoot the ball in the corner for 18 feet away, he will be scored a defense.
Good basket by Alvin Edmonds. Now he gets it to Ken, back to Edmonds, over to Melvin Jones. Edmonds, the quarterback right now.
Virginia State is a good team defense themselves in the zone.
Ken King, Phillip Jumper is good from about 15 feet out. And he's running to the bottom of the middle. Nice shot. 17-4. Virginia State, 15 minutes to play in the ball game. End of the ball game for Virginia State. Todd Perry, Joe Britt, Douglas Hines, Richard Hickford, and Kevin Oliver. And a shot by Hickford is no good. Here comes Ken King with a basketball. King, a cross court to Barry Towns. Phillip Jumper, no good. The big man pulled up from the wall outside. And with a rebound, here comes Joe Britt for three. No good. Rebound Hines. Back up strong. And it rolls out. Hines gets the rebound again, and he's fouled.
Hines hustling all over the court that time. He's a thin man, but he really likes to get a body in on the inside and try to create havoc. And he does. The first one fouled with him, he says to number five, Elvin Edmonds. And Edmonds, that is his first personal team's second in half. Edmonds is getting left behind the other line and shoot two for the Trojans.
What a seven. Douglas Hines and Edmonds. For Virginia State, I mean, he's been there every night. The only night he's really played a ball game were the nights when they really double-timed and triple-timed and checked him and slapped him and run him down all over the court. But he's still managing to come away with a passing rebound. And behind, it's one of two free throws, 58-24. Here comes Melvin Jones. It's charged. It should be a charge from a call, but...
Shot. Gets him back out top to Elvin Edmonds.
down the corner to Jones, got the call. Then gets it to the big man, Dale Towns. Towns with a move to the basket. And Ricky Whitfield and sister Towns pushed off on a play, but that's
Ricky was right with Dale Towns. He's a big man. He was pushing his way into the lane trying to take up real estate as got up shooting guards in New York and the Atlantic City.
Well, they had more mismatch there. Dale Towns against Ricky Whitfield. That's like the defensive lineman against the punter.
No chance at all.
None whatsoever.
Stop group strength. Everything on 55 with the first pick, and Dale Towns will now have 4 points in the game, going for number five.
By the way, did I mention the Cowboys are going to win tomorrow?
They should have been convincing me, no problem. A lot of 49er fans may not think so, but you got to win closer to the truth and be make a destiny tomorrow in Texas Stadium.
I'm being disappointed by he's a staunch giant fan.
Yes.
But we passed that brother off. Dale Towns hits the free throw. 60-48 Virginia State, 13-20 on the clock. First time through. It's around the group. Right across half court, back to Pay. Pay makes a move into the lane. Gets it over to Whitfield for three. Yes! Whitfield, Virginia State, a 15-point lead in this ball game, and that is 16 points now in this game for Ricky Whitfield.
By far his best offensive output of the season.
Kevin King, one-on-one move, no good. Fourth and shot, he is paid with a basketball for VSU. Gets it over to Joe Brent, hits the three, no good. Rebound, Hines, tap up, no good. Rebound back to Pay, Pay way outside. Gets it to Brent, another look at the basket. Here's Whitfield for three, no good. Rebound, Marvin Jones, here comes St. Paul. Finally, they get the ball to Madison Jackson, back to three, no good. Rebound, Brent, and the action is getting fast paced. Here comes Douglas Hines, over to Whitfield, and now charge called against Douglas Hines on that fast break.
You have to say number 55, who some way got back with his 255 points. He was picking up the charging time on Douglas Hines. Just as just, he's throwing the first level of cards at the 4.7 remaining, and Virginia State leading 63-48 over the Tigers at St. Paul's.
Over there brings the basketball. Madison Jackson in the corner to number 10, that is Ron Lyles, now in the ball game. And here's Towns, inside, scoring the basketball. 18-50, Virginia State.
They're going downtown, gets the basket for the Tigers, and they cut the lead to 13 for Virginia State.
Well, he's still not as big as my man at North Carolina Central, putting up a 3-point down
there. Scott
Stewart. Tom Payne, moving to the rack, is fouled. Yeah, Scott Stewart. Big man, I'll tell you. Little bigger than my man, but he's got no inside playing whatsoever. He's all over there. He's always hanging around the 3-point line.
Out of time, was he sits on the same Paul's Towers field, you don't have a number of fast field right now, but it serves in bad times if the Towns gets in the three. That's going to set him clear, and 80% free throw shooter on the line to shoot two.
First shot is up, and it's good for Todd Kane. But Dan Stewart, 4 points lead on this ball game. Don't forget, coming to town next Saturday night, 1 week from tonight, at the Spartans of Norfolk State University. Here's Ricky Whitfield, who is on the top of the missed free throw, and Whitfield, quite a bit of another basket, that's 18 points tonight for Ricky Whitfield. 66-50, Trojans are just out of hustling since the ball game last play.
We're doing it up right now on the offensive and defensive game.
Melvin Jones for three, no good. And a push off on one side. They're going to call it against the Kelvin King, I believe. Now they're going to call it foul against the number 10, and that's going to be against the St. Paul's.
That's
right.
That's Ron Lyles. He was a starter last year in the game with Taylor Whitehead Jordan, and he has been with Bruce Field Road coming off the bench, and he was a guard, a sophomore, standing 5'9 for Washington, D.C.
Jerome Brent with the basketball, gets it up there in the corner to Woodfield. Woodfield having one heck of a night for the Trojans. Here's Kelvin Kinney, and his shot rejected. Got the rebound, put it back up again, but still no good. Madison Jackson now the ball for St. Paul's, got him away and out of bounds.
And he was one of the people from the Jerry State who always stopped on defense. If you're not sweating, we're in every night with the NFL of the Olympics. And he's one of those guys who just gives it 110% every time he puts on that number 12 from the Jerry State University.
Of course, Rick Fourth and assist. And like the Rams, there's also somebody like 9th or 10th in skills. But it's a Jerry Rick that got on the ball during this season for Virginia State. 16-point lead now for the Trojans, 11-8 to play the ball game. Out of bounds for St. Paul's is Madison Jackson. Jackson in bounds to Edmonds. Edmonds calls a play for St. Paul's. He gets it to Alvin Jones, who throws a crooked shot up there, and it's no good. Rebound of Towns, no good. Jones in rebound, he goes up for the shot, and he finally gets it to fall for 2 points. 66-62, Trojan comes up by 14 points. He has no good back down court for VSU. St. Paul's in the 2-1-2 to close the ball. He's out of the corner and hit there. No good. That's killing it tonight.
Billy Whitley trying to hook it in and get that ball, but it bounces out of bounds out of his hands. And St. Paul's is trying to cut back into a 13-point lead. The Green State University set up in a trapping defense, and they're applying the trap right now.
Ron Lyons in the basketball gets it over to Melvin Jones, who's tripped and missed the shot. Rebound, Calvin Kenny, strong rebound. Here comes Virginia State, 3-on-2. Todd Pay in the corner to Whitfield. Great move, but he's traveled.
Excellent move that time by Todd Pay. He had him in the middle. In between him and the basket, Whitfield was all alone in the middle of the corner. He was out in the alley behind the basket. Whitfield, but Whitfield just couldn't control his feet as they were traveling before the ball hit the hardwood. Turning of Virginia State.
10 minutes to play in the ball game. Virginia State on defense as Logan Jones for St. Paul's has his shot rejected by Holloman after his third block of the night. And now a call by the official.
It's 10-0 remaining. It definitely is more than 2 seconds to waste off the clock.
And the Lions gets the ball into Madison Jackson. They swung it inside to Logan Jones. And the foul is called at the end of the line. They're going to take it out of bounds.
That's on Richard Whitfield. And for Whitfield, that's his third person. It's a foul trouble really running up for Virginia State right now. As Howell has 3 assists and a bit before, Whitfield 3 for the Trojans.
Logan Jones and the inbounds almost stolen away by Virginia State. Lyles is trapped. He gets it to Jones. Jones behind the back, a travel call. And a little too much Dixie Dewey. That is so good.
That's good. You got the assist off to the man down in the paint that was fouled. And it's just the turnover was fouled. And now we have a timeout at the same time.
Saturday the 29th against Norfolk State. Girls game 5:30, boys game 7:30.
And he will score 4 from the charity strike as well.
Richard Whitfield, pull-up jumper from about 15 feet, no good. Here's Haskett, and Haskett with a great chance, but it's knocked away and stolen by Virginia State.
Whitfield with a basket back. Not a quick back to Whitfield. And Whitfield will set up the offense for Virginia State, trapped out there on the backcourt. Now to Whitfield. Inside pass to Kelvin Kinney. Turn around. And KT can't get the shot to fall, but he gets the foul. And Kinney will go to the line to shoot two for Virginia State.
Michael, I missed the crowd. That would be number four. That is number four in town. So that was an instrumental foul at time by Kelvin Kinney. But Kinney has the ball right where he needs to have the ball. And then he's going to be in the middle of the game. About 5 to 10 feet away from the basket, so he can use his strength to get in the air quickly and get off a good shot.
St. Paul's apparently has a great team. They're not that bad, at least as the record shows. But they would come in and play the quarterback game. A lot of turnovers and some bad passes, but other than that, they've been right here in the ball game with Virginia State. 6'7" 15 now. Georgia, he's Bell Towns, a big man. And they moved to the basket, they moved to the lane, and everybody got out of the way. 6'7" 15 9 points for Towns in this ball game. Todd Pillman out of the ball for Virginia State. This is over to Whitman. Whitman moved to the inside, lays it up off the glass, no good. Rebound, Calvin Kinney, strong putback, no good. Rejected, stolen away by Melvin Jones, and he's out of the way for the breakaway. And he reverses it, couldn't get all the way up to the slam, though.
He had to think of mid-air what to do, how to suck it down, but he does get what he needs, get 2 points.
That's right, he put the ball in the lane, that's all that's important. Here's Kevin Harlan saving the pass and drawing it in to Calvin Kinney, who scores the basket for the Trojans. 69-56, 13-point lead for Virginia State. With the ball is Mario Haskett. Gets it to Tim King, who travels as the leader of the basket. Drag that right in the middle. And the official right there on the spot to call it.
Well, Tim coming into the game after a short break around the rim of 50 double times. They took out Ricky Whitfield. The leader Trojans with 18, and also Willie Whitfield.
Well, it's very convenient. We're going to take a look for it on and put on a double times. Here's Todd Pillage, he didn't catch back. He gets it to Kelvin Kinney. Missed the shot, but the follow. And now they say no good.
Oh, my God.
What kind of call is this?
Look at the time, says the ball, though. A foot away from the middle of the time. Oh, the foot by. And they call offensive goal to me. And during this time, they're gaining an excellent foot by from the sophomore.
Well, yes, you can't really know. 69-56 is Melvin Jones. He has been really contesting the Trojans. They're going to go to the basket, but so far, he has been unable to really get the job done. And now Mr. Towns goes into the lane, and again, he clears that way. Well, he's coming. Everybody has it coming out.
They had a whole lot of mistakes, so he's not in the heat for him. He's playing a stone burner. Well, Towns is that type of a player. He's a big man, standing about 260, 265 in the lane for those Tigers. And his first and final time was set for Kelvin Kinney. This goal.
Virginia State up by 13 points in this ball game. And Towns misses a free kick.
He'll be awarded one more for the 30-something. Dale Towns is really not a very good speaker shooting, shooting under 50% from the line.
Towns at the line for the second shot. This shot is up, and it's good. 69-57, 21 million for Virginia State. Whitman checks back in for Douglas High. And finds the ball there in the lane stage of the driveway. Field run across half court now. It's in the hands of Kevin Holliman. Inside of Calvin Kinney makes a strong move to the basket. And when he turned around, there is nobody running. And Calvin Kinney lays it up and in for Virginia State. 71-57. 3-point attempt by Tim King. No good. Rebound. St. Paul's. Melvin Jones in the basketball. Gets it back to King inside. Up the window, but he can't get the shot to fly. He does, however, get the foul.
And the foul will be assessed to number 34, the James State, Kevin Holliman. He does speak up
second. First one, the same cars, even though they are down 51-57, it's still dividing like two titles in this contest. They may not die, they may not need a big win, and they're trying to upset the Georgia State University in the contest.
7-0-6 to play in the ballgame, 71-57. Didn't turn off the line, first shot is up the next day. Richard Winfield about to check off Winfield, Virginia State.
Trying to get the ball to tie past the three-point line to make one shot.
Four points total for the senior.
76-61. Tim King gets it to Anthony Williams. Williams inside, pass to Madison Jackson, and he lays it up and in after he moves to the other side of the basket to get a better shot. Good job by Madison Jackson. It's Todd Payton, King. And the rebound comes up again by Kevin Holliman. Holliman now is setting himself in the ball game. 9 points here so far in the contest for the Cutter's Grand Senior. Kevin Holliman.
Virginia University doing a good job in the second half of getting more people to the scoring column.
And Melvin Jones missed another shot. Melvin Jones set up half of the first half before checking into the ball game. And, really just has never found his
game here. I saw him like a hound dog all over the 94 by 50. Virginia State University has 7 players right now to have a score for Harry Gaines' team.
Here's Marion Haskin pull up, no ball, rebound with me, but it's picked up by
Tigers, Madison Jackson, who now has 11.
Jackson picks it up and lays it in for St. Paul. Todd Payne paid away to the corner, and that shot is also good. Here's a takeaway by Whitfield, all the way to the basket. Virginia State, all of a sudden, has put the lid on this ball game. That is 20 points here tonight for Whitfield out of Metoka High School. 82-65, Virginia State in control. Mario Haskin with the basketball. Gets it over to Melvin Jones. Back to Haskin, pulled away into the backcourt, but it's saved by Haskin. He gets it to Jones between the legs. Great move, but to no avail, a foul is going to be called against Gerald Britt. But what a one-on-one movement time by Melvin Jones.
You can see why he is one of the explosive players in the Seattle game. He's moving well around Gerald Britt by like a lot of kids in the lane. And Britt had no running. He was on the line of Melvin Jones, and Jones is going to be rewarded at the free throw line to shoot two.
Melvin Jones, of course, came into this basketball game as the CIAA leading the score, fourth leading score, I should say. He got 11 points in the ball game. And now maybe 12.
Jones is trying to set himself for 322 remaining, but Virginia University has a really comfortable lead right now with 322 remaining. That's a very serious remaining contest. Virginia State has 8 points total in the contest, but he also is playing with 4 personal fouls.
Virginia State had a chance to pick up another CIAA Northern Division runner tonight. And that will be sitting pretty with Union and Hampton playing tonight. Also, Union up City and Norfolk State getting it on tonight down in North Carolina. So this turns out to be a pretty good ball game for the Trojans. Looking with me at the basketball. Makes a move left. Looking back to play. Almost taken away, and it is. And the foul is going to be called against Haskin and over on the Virginia State fan. That was really awesome. On the part of Mario Haskin. Actually, I thought he should have got the foul called this time.
When you try to step right into the passing lane, it's 22. Richard Whitfield was defended ferociously by Anthony Williams. He tried to go to the pass in the middle of the court to Todd Payne. The pass did not quite get there, but it was enough to cause a personal foul to be called on the 34. Mario Haskin, he picked up his second. Team 7 in this half.
Todd Payne off an iron to shoot 2-1-1, I should say. And the first shot falls for Todd Payne, 83-67. I'm with you, but I tell you the Cowboys are going to win.
They're going to win soundly. There will be no question the San Francisco comes from the Bay Area to take care of business in Texas Stadium. It will not be enough business because Texas Cowboys, Dallas Cowboys, that is, will get that victory tonight. They're going to Super Bowl 28 up to game
9. Todd Payne makes both free throws for Virginia State. And now St. Paul's has thrown the ball away. And the Trojans get the ball back. They have 467 with 2:52 to play. 17-point lead for the Trojans.
Could be the highest output by the Virginia State. They scored 90 against Benedict College in a losing time.
Todd Payne with the basketball. Payne makes a move into the paint, and he gets opposition. How in the world can that be a charge when a man practically left his feet on the defensive side? and the official calls a challenge.
Out of position all the way on that play. And as I said, we have three officials on the floor. That's why they come to the Celtics and try to agree with the charge. I was there bad part of time as a defender, number 24, Norman Jones, stepped right into the lane to stop over and play with Edwin.
We're going to need to use an instant replay on the side of the
NFL. Yeah, and a lot of equipment in the NFL not being used.
Addison Jackson has his ball batted away, but it falls to the hands of the Bill Montgomery. And Montgomery brings it in for St. Paul's 84-69, now Trojan. Ripped up off the 15. Here's Willie Whitmore with the basketball. That's a good ball. Sears inside, and Sears gets robbed of the ball. And a little bit of contact as well. Foul called on the play.
And the hand is there for St. Paul's side. As for Darrell Towns, as for the St. Paul's. And there are all these people in deep foul trouble right now for the Tigers.
Darrell Towns at the line for a huge hit.
He's going to try to reach double figures. So he's not going to do it this time down court. He has 8 points so far in the contest. And he's trying to get the number 9 right now from the training staff.
So his second shot is good. Sears does have back-to-back 20-point games. And the two wins over Elizabeth City and Hampton. 85-69 Trojans. A minute 57 on the clock. It is Mario Haskett. Haskett with the basketball. Inside pass to Montgomery. Great spin move. Missed the shot, however. And Montgomery fights for the rebound, throws it in. Towards St. Paul's. And Robin a little bit disgusted with himself on that play. 6 points now for Montgomery on the ball game. Across half court, real quick. 1:34 on the clock. This guy pretty much in hand for the Trojans. And Kevin Holloman is fouled.
I mean, they went right to the matchup. They should have went to. Kevin Holloman was good on Rudy Winkle. Rudy Winkle gets close to his score. Kevin Holloman is 6'8". Big did the right thing and get the pass to the Holloman, but Rudy Winkle came through with the thunderous pipe that time, knocking Kevin Holloman to the floor, and it struck Zubik. I thought a good thing situated right now. Kevin Holloman is good.
And Kevin Holloman needs to be careful after what has happened to Thomas Morris. Meredith, of course, that we talked about earlier, who plays for Virginia Union, has been ejected twice this season. And the one thing Kevin Holloman does not want now is an ejection. Because later on in the season, after London, that right there is just another example of what I said at the beginning of the ball game. Kevin Holloman, a very frustrated ball player, has not been able to get into his game. The last three or four times out has been shut down on the inside pretty much, and he just hasn't been able to get off, and the frustration has been showing on the face of Kevin Allen in the last three or four ball games. And I think that there is basically a combination. Winning free throw shooter in the CIAA, and he is good on the first attempt. Second shot up and on the way to a double high. And that shot is no good.
Double time for 14 in the contest. Kevin Holloman 9, Hayes 15. And this field leads the Georgia State University East Flying with a total of 20.
Now Hines will attempt two other shots.
He shouldn't shoot a point, but he is the top
people shooting in the conference. And again, Hines makes the shot. 87-71, Virginia State. Hines with a fourth attempt, and that one also good. Trojans up 88-71. Now we'll parade down to the St. Paul game. And we'll have St. Paul issue to be done as well. And this is a good game going to the line for St. Paul. Really, all of this is ridiculous because it will have absolutely no bearing on the basketball game.
That really will, because the outcome is out right now. The Georgia State University is leading something right now by 17. Georgia State is set to be 16. The Virginia State University is in the final of the world, and the world is in the second place. And we are awaiting the outcomes of Norfolk State, and we will see Hampton and also Virginia Union tonight.
And Harold Green now sits down, Todd Kay, and Jill Brooks. Youngstown's Willie Woodley and Sean Miller into the ball game. So we'll get back to action. It's going to be a hit field. Kenny, back in corner, Whitney and Sean Miller. Inbounds from King. He gets it to Haskett. Haskett across the half-court line. We're finally back to action. 88-72 Trojans. 1:20 on the clock. Here's Haskett. Make a move from the inside. Pass, a great one, to Anthony Williams. And Williams lays it up to him. Check that. That was the Ruben Wilson. He's going to basket 6 foot junior from Newport News. And Sean Miller for three is no good. But apparently a foul is going to be called on the inside away from the ball. And that foul is
It's a personal foul.
That's personal. It's 10 King. It's 4. And Mr. King.
He's trying to figure out getting put out of here in this game. So that's what I'm saying. Richie Winfield on the line to add to his game high total of 20.
And Winfield hits the free throw. The Green State's going to move to 7-8 overall. They're going to be 4-5 in the CIAA and 3-2 in the Northern Division. And bearing on what happens tonight between Norfolk State and Oregon City and Virginia Union and Hampton, Virginia State could be in right there, tied for second with only one team. And now a score, but the basket is way back.
They're just getting tangled all over the court. Richie Whitfield got tangled at that time with number 20, same time as Anthony Williams. And for Richie Whitfield, that is coming on the court. It's about half a minute right now. The Virginia State University, 3.1 remaining, will have a victory and stay in second place in the Northern Division. Trojans have a game number as well, Mitch.
That's right. Johnson C. Smith on the road in Charlotte, North Carolina. And with that also, it'll be a crucial ball game for Virginia State, although it won't have any bearing on their CIAA Northern Division standards.
It will be in the CIAA, but people don't look for that night. You're talking about a sophomore who's really doing wonders in the CIAA. I'm talking about Tyrone Satterfield, who, as a freshman, also came to the games winning at the Golden Bulls in scoring that night with 26. They had a lot of people to speak from last year. Robert Borkins is a key person for John C. Smith as well. He's shooting a good percentage from the field. He's one of the best in the CIAA at game ducks. And he was also one of the leading rebounders in the league as well. So a tough opponent Monday night in Charlotte as Virginia State University takes the high flying out of the road to take on the Golden Bulls of John C. Smith University.
And the ball game on that panel, Robert Olson apparently has received the final uniform of St. Paul's Nature Actor. As his uniform is distinctly different from all the rest.
He has white numbers, and the people in St. Paul's tell us has black numbers. He has his new stuff, and he's ready for work tonight, and as he said, I think they had to look green within the miles to get a uniform out from Mr. Wilson.
No doubt about it. Of course, Mr. Wilson is a very good ball player, and good point in attendance.
His mom is in attendance tonight as well. I like to say I'm hello to him as well.
90-75, Virginia State, 53.1 seconds to go. And missing the free throw is Marlon Lancaster. And the whistle is Virginia State on the run with a rebound. Jose Hyde is fouled. And he is pretty much he's got to go out to the free throw line the rest of the way. 48 seconds to play. 15.1. Well, the Trojans pick up another important CIAA Northern Division victory. And again, as I said, barring what happens tonight in Hampton, Virginia State will be tied with only one team for second place in the CIAA North.
What about the things that went on Northern State does tonight in Virginia City? So, no, they can't do that.
But a loss by Norfolk State tonight would make them.
Thank you.
the Trojans, number 55, Marcus Taylor, his third. At the line for the Trojans, at the line for the Tigers, number 24, Melvin Jones. Foul called on the Tigers, number 34, Mario Haskett, his third. Shooting two for the Trojans, number 13, Sean Miller. Basket good by number 12, Marlon Lancaster. Tigers basket good by number 3, Ruben Wilson. Turnover by the Tigers, Trojans basketball.